Today, Hillary Clinton revealing her official economic plan.
You can't solve our problems without economic growth. Growth creates jobs and prosperity, and that is the glue that binds our society together.
Okay, so, Stuart, you say there's a clear choice. Hillary Clinton wants to make us more like Europe. Donald Trump wants to make us grow again.
That's my opinion.
With all sorts of stuff. What's the matter with Europe?
What's the matter with Europe?
What's the matter with Europe for the folks at home? You remember you're a refugee.
I am a refugee from European socialism. It's not a sustainable model. They're bankrupt. Many of those societies are bankrupt.
They're super
They've had
in the
no
red.
Growth, virtually no growth, for many, many years. Their population is actually declining and it's aging. That is not a sustainable economic model. It's just not. It mounts out in terms of growth and expansion. Donald Trump would lower taxes for individuals and for corporations. He would cut regulation. He would encourage domestic energy expansion and output. That's a recipe for vigorous growth in the economy. And look, we're in decline.
What I've heard people say, they like Donald Trump's plan because he takes it from four brackets to three brackets. Everyone gets benefits because everyone's going to have their taxes lowered.
Trump wants to cut taxes for the super rich. Well, we're not going there, my friends. I'm telling you right now, we're going to write fairer rules for the middle class, and we aren't going to raise taxes on the middle class. Trump wants to cut taxes for the super rich. Well, we're not going there, my friends. I'm telling you right now, we're going to write fairer rules for the middle class, and we aren't going to raise taxes on the middle class.
The purpose of the SIP is to, quote, provide accurate and comprehensive information about the income and program participation that has constantly been screamed down, that you constantly call xenophobic, racist, Nazi, whatever. Well, it turns out that intuition, that instinct that you had, yeah, it's correct.
When do we beat Mexico at the border? They're laughing at us, at our stupidity. And now they're beating us economically. They are not our friend.
Black people and white people can't be unified for Trump? That's bullcrap.
Trump refuses to denounce the KKK.
How do you feel about the recent endorsement from David Duke?
I didn't even know he endorsed me. David Duke endorsed me? Okay. All right. I disavow. Okay? Yes. Yes.
In the absence of the truth, bullcrap prevails. So here come the truth jokers. Look at what's been going on. All the people are coming out the dang walking dead. You know, the people who don't pay attention to politics until the election cycle comes around. And they get so emotional. They get all into it and, you know, they pick their sides and they fight against each other, but in reality, they ain't getting nowhere with it. So you're falling for the little racist angle. You're fighting each other. You're ripping up the signs. And, oh yeah, let me go to this. This is something here. How is it that this little fake joker right here comes out and endorses Donald Trump? Now, elections are all about perception. So when you see this guy endorsing Donald Trump, you say, oh, well, Donald Trump is a racist. Because he's endorsing Donald Trump. But here's the thing. What is KKK? Well, the KKK was created by the Democrats. KKK still belongs to the Democrats. So this guy right here knows that if he comes out and throws his support behind Donald Trump, it's going to get the reaction of this. That's the only reason why he's coming out and doing that. Lyndon B. Johnson did the same thing in the 1964 election. He made an ad saying that Barry Goldwater was endorsed by the KKK. But how is he going to say that when the KKK is a Democratic entity? They are the problem, and I'm talking about the KKK. The Democrats are the most racist party in history, the only party in American history to kill black people because they wanted them to vote Democrat. Lyndon B. Johnson said, I'll have those N-words voting Democrat for the next 200 years. When he was talking about N-words, he was talking about black people, and black people, they still vote Democrat.
Neither have I.
You don't know me.
You're fucking a white male.
No.
Today, our country has lost a true American original, my friend and mentor, Robert C. Byrd. Senator Byrd was a man of surpassing eloquence and nobility.
There are white. I've seen a lot of white in my time.
I admired his tireless advocacy for his West Virginia constituents, his fierce defense of the Constitution and the traditions of the Senate, and his passion for a government that improves the lives of the people it serves.
There are white. I've seen a lot of white in my time.
They mentioned that he once had a fleeting association with a Ku Klux Klan. What does that mean? I'll tell you what it means. He was a country boy from the hills and hollows of West Virginia. He was trying to get elected.
As Secretary of State, I continued to rely on his advice and counsel. Robert C. Byrd led by the power of his example, and he made all of us who had the honor of serving as his colleagues better public servants and better citizens. Robert C. Byrd left such a legacy.
We have given her $20,000 anonymously for her campaign fund. She is friends with the Klan. The KKK endorses Hillary Clinton. About illegal immigrants. She doesn't. She's acting like she does so she can get into office. She's a Democrat. The Klan has always been a Democratic organization.
People in the streets.
Hitler not remind you of that? Does Trump not remind you of that?
No, explain to me how Trump is like Hitler.
Mass deportation.
There isn't any sensible approach except to do what we need to do simultaneously. You know, secure our borders with technology, personnel, physical barriers if necessary in some places, and we need to have tougher employer sanctions, and we need to try to incentivize Mexico to do more. If they committed transgressions of whatever kind, they should be obviously courted.
Sessions went on to explain that Obama's immigration policy is killing wages, particularly for immigrants and minority groups, because the flow of labor is so large, it floods the labor market and depresses wages. Of the Daily Caller, Donald Trump is going to do better with Hispanics and African Americans because he's talking about things that will really make their wages go up.
I do not support gay marriage.
I live in New York. New York is a place with lots of gays, and I think it's great.
I'd be sure if we
mass abortion, so obey the law. Donald Trump wants to obey the laws on immigration. Donald Trump wants to vet.
And basically, fuck with the one person who stands in the way of us being ruled by Donald Trump.
Just before I came in here, we thought we'd do a little search on our files, and I do notice that a William Mayer gave a Clinton-affiliated entity $1 million. Now, it's a William Mayer in L.A. where that at the time money came. Perhaps you would like to comment. Is that you?
Yeah, I don't think...
For the KKK, Hillary Clinton is our choice.
Wow.
I can promise you the best way to show respect outside of rebuilding our military to men and women in uniform is to fix that mess as fast as I can.
Get them out of here. Get out.
That's it. Thank you. They're kicking me out the door. They're kicking me out the door.
Foolish blackboard merchants.
Is it the truth? Is it fair?
Despite its impressive length, it's a nimble navigator, and some can be highly venomous.
All I'm doing is telling the truth.
Just like the tarantula it's killing, the centipede has two curved, hollow fangs, which inject paralyzing venom.
This one I like. Here you go, folks. Enjoy it.
Yeah, maybe get
this
the remnant out.
This centipede is a predator.
You're not a very good reporter doing that. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, Bush. Get him out of here. Get out.
They asked Ted Cruz, serious question, well, what do you think of waterboarding? Is it okay? And honestly, I thought he'd say absolutely, and he didn't. He said, well, it's, you know, he's concerned about the answer because some people, she just said a terrible thing. You know what she said? Shout it out because I don't want to. Okay, you're not allowed to say, and I never expect to hear that from you again. She said, I never expect to hear that from you again. She said he's a pussy. That's terrible. Terrible.
Why don't you apologize to her?
No, I won't
right
do that
now.
Because I said nothing wrong.
From an elderly woman.
Let me talk. Quiet. Help.
You can't stump the Trump.
Another presidential debate.
I don't think this one would be very good, Lindsay.
Why is that, John?
Because I want a divorce.
And lastly, we welcome back to the debate stage, Donald Trump.
Can I introduce
don't know
Casey?
Anything in here. Yes, yes.
Judgment and resolve to keep this country safe from radical Islamic terrorism.
Senator Cruz, thank you. We're going to continue on this notion of readiness and
am
experience.
I to, am
I'm going
to
come
to
back.
Respond? I have to respond.
If you'd like to respond, Mr. Trump.
First of all, I respect what Ted just said. But if you noticed, he didn't answer your question. And that's what's going to happen. It's okay. That's what's going to happen with our enemies and the people we compete against. We're going to win with Trump. We're going to win.
And let's dispel once and for all with this fiction that Barack Obama doesn't know what he's doing. He knows exactly what he's doing. Barack Obama is undertaking a systematic effort to change this country, to make America more like the rest of the world. That's why he passed Obamacare and the stimulus and Dodd-Frank and a deal with Iran. It is a systematic effort to change America.
Fact is, when you talk about Hezbollah Sanctions Act that you list as one of your accomplishments and just did, you weren't even there to vote for it. That's not leadership, that's truancy.
But I would add this, let's dispel with this fiction that Barack Obama doesn't know what he's doing. He knows exactly what he's doing. He is trying to change this country.
You see, everybody, I want the people at home to think about this. That's what Washington, D.C. does. The drive-by shot at the beginning with incorrect and incomplete information, and then the memorized 25-second speech that is exactly what his advisors gave him.
Chris, your state got hit by a massive snowstorm 2 weeks ago. You didn't even want to go back. They had to shame you into going back.
And then, oh, fuck. Marco stepped in it now.
You stayed there for 36 hours, and then he left and came back to campaign.
See,
those are the facts. Here's the bottom line. This notion that Barack Obama doesn't know what he's doing is just not
there
true.
There it is.
He knows exactly what's
happening. There it is.
Exactly
there it is.
Exactly
there it is. The memorized 25-second speech.
Well, that's
there it
the reason
is, everybody.
Why this campaign is so important.
Governor Christie,
Chris, why don't you make know what my the shame is?
Get into this.
You know what?
Shut up, Jeb.
The shame is, Marco, the shame is that you would actually criticize somebody for showing up to work, plowing the streets, getting the trains run back on time, when you've never been responsible for
Chris,
that in your entire life.
Okay. And he didn't want to go back.
And And the fact is, I went back, it got done, and here's
something. You didn't want to go back.
I went back. Oh, so wait a second. Is that one of the skills you get as a United States Senator, ESP also?
Chris, everybody, you said you weren't going to go back.
The fact is, Marco.
He told everyone he wasn't going to go back, and they had to shame him into going back.
Marco, because.
And then when he decided to go back, he criticized the young lady saying, what
Marco,
am I supposed
you know
to do,
what?
Go back with a mop?
By the way,
clean up the flooding?
It gets very unruly when he gets off his talking.
Thank you, Governor.
Surely Marco Rubio just had a bad night. Surely this won't happen again, right?
Re-election to the Senate and I'm running for president. This notion and this idea that somehow all this is an accident. Obamacare was not an accident. Dodd-Frank was not an accident. I'm going to keep saying that because that not only is it the truth, it is at the core of our campaign.
But even after Chris Christie called you up for what he called canned speeches, 25-second canned speeches, you repeated again. He says, there you go. Again, that was not a good moment for you, was it?
It's what I believe. And if
we are taking our message to families that are struggling to raise their children in the 21st century, because as you saw, Jeanette and I are raising our four children in the 21st century. And we know how hard it's become to instill our values in our kids. Instead of the values they try to ram down our throats. In the 21st century, it's become harder than ever to instill in your children the values they teach in our homes and in our church, instead of the values that they try to ram down our throats.
Holy shit, he did it again. What is going on? It seems that Team Marco has become unhinged. Someone help that brave lad.
Why do you have your hands on me?
Holy fucking shit. Team Marco beat up Reddit.
That is downright wrong. Hey, and here's the problem with that.
Right. Okay.
The problem was it was to tear down. Jeb wants to be a tough guy tonight. Trump, take 30 seconds, please.
A lot of times you'll have, and it doesn't work very well with
how
this.
Tough is it
a
to
lot
take
of times,
property from an elderly
talk,
woman?
Let me talk quiet.
How tough
a lot
is
of
it?
Times. That's all of his donors and special interests out there. So, that's what it is. That's what. And by the way, let me just tell you, we need the tickets. You can't get them. You know who has the tickets for the? I'm talking about to the television audience. Donors, special interests, the people that are putting up the money. So it is. The RNC told us we have all donors in the audience, and the reason they're not loving me. The reason they're not loving me is I don't want their money. I'm going to do the right thing for the American public. I don't want their money. I don't need their money. And I'm the only one up here that can say that.
Then no one fears us, and they take actions that are against our national interest.
Tell me what you'd say to American people out there who are sitting at home, who have daughters,
yeah,
who might worry about those answers and might
worry that the draft is reinstituted. Well, the draft's not going to be reinstituted.
Foolish guagbold merchant.
I don't know, lads. Perhaps calling Ted Cruz a pussy will finally be what stumps the Trump. Let's hope for the best. Here we go.
Makes two projections in New Hampshire. CNN projects that Donald Trump will be the winner of the New Hampshire Republican primary.
Up as we go on, in the Republican race, Donald Trump is the projected winner of the New Hampshire primary.
ABC News projects that Donald Trump will win. That is based on the exit polls and some votes already counted.
Fox News can now project that Donald Trump will win the Republican presidential primary based on Fox exit polls and...
Thank everybody, but I really have to begin by paying homage to my parents, Mary and Fred. They're up there, they're looking down, they're saying, This is something very special. They love this country, and they're very, very happy right now. So thank you to my parents. I want to thank my brother, my late brother, Fred. What a fantastic guy. I learned so much from Fred. Taught me more than just about anything. Just probably about even with my father. A fantastic guy. So I want to thank Fred. He's up there, and he's looking down also. We have political hacks negotiating our deals for billions and billions and billions of dollars. Not going to happen anymore. We're going to use the finest business people in the world. We are going to do something so good and so fast and so strong, and the world is going to respect us again. Believe me. We are going to start winning again. We don't win anymore as a country. We don't win on trade. We don't win with the military. We can't beat ISIS. We don't win with anything. We are going to start winning again. And we're going to win so much. You are going to be so happy. We are going to make America so great again, maybe greater than ever before. I love you all. Thank you, New Hampshire. Thank you. Thank you, New Hampshire. Thank you. We are going now to South Carolina. We're going to win in South Carolina. I love you all. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Oh my God. Chris Christie sacrificed his life to destroy Rubio. He did his part to make America great again. Godspeed, you glorious fat man.
This notion that Barack Obama doesn't know what he's doing is just not
true. There it is.
He knows exactly what he's doing.
The memorized 25-second speech. Wait a second. Is that one of the skills you get as a United States Senator? ESP also.
Very nice young man, a very confused fellow, apparently in the Bernie Sanders campaign. You know, I'm curious.
Look at yourself in the mirror!
He looks like a nervous wreck. He's going down. He had his moment.
The future must not belong to those who slander the prophet of Islam.
ISIS will be using the refugee crisis, the global refugee crisis, to place their foreign fighters on Western soil. I've known about it. We've talked about it here on The Rebel. We've talked about it elsewhere. We've also been denounced as bigots, as racist for saying such things. But ISIS has said this up front, and they've already done it in several instances. But more has to be done to push back against this group that is making tens of millions of dollars per month, according to Brennan, through both taxation and black market oil supplies. That's money that will continue to fund terrorism, that will continue to fund propaganda that is used to, well, bring about sympathizers like Omar Mateen to carry out their own attacks.
As I said before, this aspect of our strategy was moving too slow, but the call of the body is galvanized by the government. So with the additional steps I ordered last month, we're speeding up training of ISIL forces, including volunteers from Sunni tribes in our province.
Shah. George Bush brought the spark of jihad to Iraq, and it flared up there. Still, nowadays it was Obama who became the 200th information of our caliphate. This great man contributed a lot to our cause. Inshallah, thanks to you Muslims brought down the regimes of the Wahid, who ruled not according to Sharia in many countries of Maghrib.
What do you think about the mosque controversy?
I think we need more mosques.
Why?
So we can show the world that we are not bigots.
But don't you know what happens in countries where Muslims rule?
I don't care. We need more hope and change.
That is crazy.
There are too many Christian fundamentalists trying to impose their views on us through government.
What?
They are trying to take over America. We need more Muslims to show the world how multicultural we are.
But don't you read about what is happening in Europe because of rampant Muslim immigration?
You must be a bigot.
Please. Let's talk about the issues. These events are important.
No. You should not be allowed to speak. You must have supported Bush. You're a hate monger.
But I'm trying to have a dialogue with you about the issues.
Your hate speech should be banned.
But don't you know that Sharia law is being implemented in many European countries with large Muslim immigrant populations?
I don't care. You're a warmonger.
But in many European cities, there are now no-go zones where non-Muslims and police cannot enter.
Islam is a religion of peace. We should welcome all of them.
Yes, but don't you think we should carefully screen which immigrants come here from Muslim countries?
No. You spread hate. I will report you for hate speech.
But don't you think Muslims need to reform their religion to embrace all cultures and renounce violence among them?
No, Muslim immigrants should come. We are a nation of immigrants.
But aren't you aware of the human rights abuses in many Muslim countries where women don't have rights and are tortured?
No. Conservative Christians oppress women's rights because they don't want women to have abortions. You must be a radical right-winger.
I simply want to have a dialogue about the issues affecting the world.
I'm going to call campus security and have you arrested for hate speech.
No, I'm not condoning hatred towards Muslims. I'm simply addressing a global concern regarding the violence and their religion. There are many who want to destroy Israel and America.
You're a fascist.
I feel like every time you want to have a sensible discussion about facts and reality and trends within society, particularly when it overlaps with any kind of politics, don't you feel like any time you want to have a sensible discussion, all of these hysterical brain parasite...
Maybe you can just say, like, what are the problems in America?
Hillary can make a case because she can say something that's actually political.
This guy don't even... Tell me the issues
in America.
What are the issues in America?
First off, people like me are dying. The banks running everything. Anybody else want to get in on
this? Okay, Donald Trump wants to bring jobs back to America. You say jobs are an issue. Donald Trump says he wants to bring them back.
I didn't say nothing about a job.
How? He quit sending jobs to China. We have companies going to Mexico. What are you talking about? Are you even listening?
I said people like me are dying.
American companies. You want to know why everything you pick up says made in China? That's because other companies devalue their currency, and so companies can make a greater profit overseas. Donald Trump wants to bring it back.
I don't trust capitalism.
This is America.
Capitalism is cannot exist without exploitation.
Didn't think so.
Let's bring it back to black people being killed by police.
Okay.
What has Trump said about that?
What about white people being killed by police?
Fuck off!
Black people! That's not racist, though!
The junior senator from Alabama went on to predict that Trump can turn the economy around for those on the lowest rung of the economic ladder very quickly.